Oh yeah, turbo button on steroids. Hi everyone and welcome. Turbo buttons are cool. They slow down the system a bit to make some speed-sensitive games more playable. But they were short-lived. Anything newer than a 486 doesn't have a turbo button. For such systems, there are ways to slow down the CPU in software. A popular program is CPU-SPD, which allows you to control things like the CPU multiplier, the caches, and in some cases even microarchitectural features like branch predictors, prefetchers, and others. The problem is that your mileage may vary depending on your CPU generation and your motherboard chipset, some of which are completely unsupported due to lack of documentation. This is where the Throttle Blaster comes in. It is a hardware solution, just like the turbo button, but it allows you to tune the CPU speed at a very fine granularity, and it supports practically every vintage system and CPU. Similar to some turbo button implementations, it works by sending a stop signal to the processor at a high frequency, effectively causing it to slow down on average. Not all turbo buttons worked in this way. For a very informative video on the topic, please refer to Necroware's excellent video. 486 or older processors have a hold pin that causes the processor to stop. Pentium or newer processors have the stop clock pin, which is meant to be used for power saving. Both have a similar effect, they will both cause the CPU to slow down. The circuit of the Throttle Blaster is quite simple. The main component is a Raspberry Pi Pico. There is a potentiometer for selecting the CPU speed. There is also an optional 7-segment display based on the TM1637 or similar driver chips. Finally, there is a transistor that pulls down the processor's stop clock pin. Connecting to the stop clock pin can be done in two ways. The first is to simply solder a cable to the socket pin at the back of the motherboard. The second way is to use a very thin wire, like the ones used for e-work, and insert it into the socket hole along with the CPU. This may potentially damage the socket, but it's another option. Okay, let's try it out on this Pentium 3 system with an 866MHz processor. Stop clock is pin AG35. Let's try some benchmarks. Well, this benchmark seems to have a bug with CPUs that are too fast, but the reported performance is quite close to what is shown in the Throttle Blaster's display. As you can see, we can make this Pentium 3 as slow as we want. Now let's try some games. I'm going to use this AMD Athlon system. Stop clock is pin AC1, which is at a very convenient location at the outermost row of pins. Please use a very thin wire, otherwise you could damage your CPU socket. This is a 1200 MHz Athlon, but let's clock it at 866 MHz so that I won't have to reconfigure the Throttle Blaster. It would still work, but I don't have a 4-digit display to show the 1200 MHz value, and showing 866 when the CPU is running at 1200 wouldn't be great. Anyway, let's try Duke Nukem 3D. As you can see, we can slow it down so much that even the audio is starting to lag. Turning it up again completely restores the speed back to normal. Now let's try Monkey Island. This game is known to have issues initializing on faster systems, and yeah, it won't start at full speed. After rebooting and dialing down the speed, we can see that it works just fine. Okay, let's check the stop clock signal on the oscilloscope. Well, this is actually the inverse of stop clock, but it will still do for showing you how it works. When we are at maximum speed, we are not touching stop clock. Decreasing the speed sends pulses to the CPU every 200 microseconds. The duty cycle of the pulse changes as we turn the knob further. As you can see, this has an immediate effect on the game. It slows down. Turning the speed down to zero will completely stall the CPU. Okay, that's all for now. I am planning on releasing the schematics and the sources for the Throttle Blaster project soon, so please stay tuned for a follow-up video. And as always, thank you for watching and goodbye.